Welcome back to News 8 at 5:34. A lot of us, winter is just a little something to be endured on our way to balmy spring weather.
That's right, but the cold months do give us a little bit of a break from many of those biting and stinging insects that we have to experience during the warm weather. Unfortunately, there is one tiny little biter out there that's a little more cold tolerant than most.
News 8 naturalist Jack Hubley gives us a look in tonight's wild moment.
Happy New Year and welcome to winter. Even if you're no fan of cold weather, at least you're enjoying a break from stinging and biting insects, chiggers, and ticks, right? Well, yes, when it comes to bees and mosquitoes, but ticks are a different story, as Rocky Spittler points out. He writes, "Why have ticks become so abundant? It used to be that once it got cold, you didn't have to worry about them, but not anymore." And by the way, you might have noticed that Rocky is from Shenick, which is not pronounced Shoe Neck. It's kind of a suburb of the greater Denver area here in Lancaster County, for those who don't know. Rocky, I've got two words for you. Me too. I've owned hunting dogs of various breeds for more than 35 years, and in recent years I've been removing ticks from my dogs and myself every month of the year. So, Rocky, just to make sure you and I weren't imagining things, I called Steve Jacobs, my go-to entomologist guy at Penn State, and he pointed his finger at the culprit. Ixodes scapularis, the black-legged tick, also known as the deer tick or the lime tick. Take your pick. There's the little bugger at the top, pictured with two other species found here, the Lone Star tick and the dog tick. As you can see, the black-legged tick is the smallest of the bunch, and in recent years, the biggest problem. The black-legged tick transmits Lyme disease, a disease that, if not treated, can result in serious arthritis and neurological problems. Here's a graph, courtesy of the State Department of Health, that shows the dramatic increase in reported cases of Lyme in southeastern and south-central Pennsylvania since the 1980s. And here's more bad news. The black-legged tick is the most cold-tolerant of all ticks. These ticks have been documented to be active in temperatures as low as 28 degrees. That's 4 degrees below freezing. So, Rocky, it's not your imagination. Don't expect to get a break from these bloodsuckers just because it's January. The good old days for ticks and the bad old days for tick victims are now. I'm Jack Hubley, News 8.
Oh.
Ew. If you've got a wildlife question for Jack, just email it to news8@wgal.com and you just may see and hear Jack answer your question on the air. He may even do show and tell for you.
Oh, man, like the sacrifices he makes for us.